Good morning. Chapter 6, Duck Rearing. Major duck breeds, meat purpose, white pekin, Aylesbury and Muscovy duck. Actually, Muscovy is not a true duck. Duck breed for egg purpose, khaki Cumberland, Indian runner. Dual purpose, which is for meat and egg, Kuttanad duck. In Kerala, Kuttanad ducks are seen and two varieties are there, Chara and Chembali. Egg production. Egg weight is 70 grams and egg production starts in 20 weeks itself. Photo period of 14 hours is enough. And nest boxes, we should provide about one nest box for 3 layers. Feeding of duck. Restricted feeding is followed. Ducks eat voraciously, so we follow restricted feeding, and we can feed either mash or pellet to the duck, but mostly we feed wet mash, but the ideal feed is pellet. And the protein percentage of the diet is 20 during the initial stage for the ducklings, and later on it can be reduced to 18%. Housing. Commonly semi-intensive system is followed, and when we give water, there should be enough water so that the bird can dip its head inside the water. Breeding. For layer, the male-female ratio should be 1:8, and for meat breeds, it should be 1:5. That is 1 male for 5 female. And ducks breed in water, so there should be sufficient water or a pond nearby. Incubation. Ducks will never brood. So either we can use a broody hen to sit over the duck egg, or we can go for artificial method, which is the incubator and the hatcher. So 28 days is the period for hatching of the normal duck. And for Muscovy duck, it is 35 days. Brooding, 30 degrees Celsius is needed for brooding. Ducks grow rapidly, so only 4 weeks of brooding is needed. By 4 weeks, all the feathers will be there. Sex differentiation. Drake, the male one, are larger than female. Also, there is a feather called Drake feather, which is seen at the tail end of the feather. That is seen only in the male. In the picture, you can see the drake feather. So it is found only in the male. A lustrous green color is seen on the neck region or the head region of Kuttanad males. And the male duck has a softer sound and a female one has a harsh sound. Another method is the common wen sexing method. Now we can see the advantage of duck rearing over rearing chicken. About 50 more eggs we will get from a duck than a chicken. Another thing is the number of eggs is more, and along with that the cost is also more. Then the feed cost is comparatively lesser. Then there are other advantages also, like less management. We have discussed only the major points. Vaccination in duck. Mainly two vaccinations are done. One against duck plague and another one against pasteurilosis. And the symptom of pasteurilosis is that for the dead birds, there will be pinpoint hemorrhages in the internal organs. Another disease is viral hepatitis and then aflatoxicosis. Ducks are very prone to aflatoxicosis. So it is a fungal toxin, and the fungus is Aspergillus flavus. It has 4 types of toxin, and the aflatoxin B1 is very dangerous. Ducks are like very prone to this toxin. So liver is the organ affected. 0.03 ppm of this toxin is lethal for ducks. So that is very, very important. You have to keep it in mind, 0.03 ppm. And the main source of aflatoxin is groundnut. So there is no treatment actually for aflatoxicosis. We can just withdraw groundnut from ducks. And another thing which we should do is, we should prevent feeding groundnut to ducks. So we have discussed all the important points in duck rearing. In the next one, there will be questions from this chapter. Hope you all enjoyed. Thank you. Happy learning.